like scary movies experience here in Los Angeles. This is an interactive art installation that'll feature some of our favorite films, such as The Shining, A Nightmare on Elm Street, Beetlejuice, and more. It'll feature large-scale photo ops for horror fiends to get in on. I'm so excited. So, let's go in and check everything out. Insane, but I had a fun fact for The Shining. So Danny Lloyd, who played Danny, this was actually his only acting thing. He only did this movie. And also, because he was 5 years old during the filming of this movie, they kind of wanted to protect him from like the horror aspect. So Kubrick told him that it was a drama, and he actually didn't even see this movie until he was 16 years old. She's swinging with her bat. It actually took her 127 takes for that. However, it did make it into the Guinness Book of World Records. So a fun fact for the movie It, Chapter 1, was that Pennywise only has 4 minutes of dialogue in the entire film. And also, Bill Skarsgård, he trained with a contortionist for the role. A fun fact for you, obviously, in regards to Nightmare on Elm Street, is the first time that Robert Englund put on the iconic glove, he actually cut himself. How crazy is that? So we are in the Beetlejuice area, and how cute is this? So I have a fun fact for you guys. Beetlejuice was almost called Scared Sheetless. Sheetless. Warner Brothers wasn't having Beetlejuice, so they wanted house ghosts. And Tim Burton actually laughed, and he was like, how about Scared Sheetless? And then he was actually really appalled because they were actually considering that name, which is funny also. But as you can see, we've landed on Beetlejuice, so yay to that one. So another fun fact is Tim Burton's first pick for Beetlejuice was actually Sammy Davis Jr. However, Michael Keaton obviously got casted instead. Lost Boys was that Ben Stiller was almost casted as a Lost Boy. So that was like pretty mind-blowing, this entire establishment. Again, 25,000 square feet to like cover. I was pretty blown away. And the fact that you can like touch everything and take photos, it's such an experience, I swear. So obviously if you're ever in Los Angeles, you should definitely come and see it. I heard that they're trying to make it maybe a touring thing, which would be really cool. So there's also some paranormal stuff going on.
That was weird.